Thank you everyone for joining us today. This webinar is within the series of webinars where we present for you our ISV ecosystem and partners who are helping complementing our solution from many perspectives. So as you, if you were with us, we did the blockchain one with Chainstack. The second one was all the research as a service. And this webinar is for security. Security is an important topic, and we have our partner BotGuard with us. Next slide, please. So the agenda today would be a welcome and introductions, and then we will understand and we will explain what are the bot types and their impact on the infrastructure and the business, how bots are used as a part of coordinated attacks, and what is the BotGuard solution and how BotGuard solution can help us to mitigate this. And at the end, we will end with the Q&A where Bertil will be happy to answer all your questions. So I have with me Bertil Brendeke. He is the CRO of BotGuard, and myself, Ahmed. I am Vice President of Global Business Development.
Thank you for your introduction, Ahmed, and happy to be here representing BotGuard. And as you said, cybersecurity is one of the biggest threats on the internet, of course. And we don't pretend that we will safeguard everything and everybody, but we try to contribute to a safer, better internet world, and by actually mitigating malicious bots. And I sincerely hope to take you through our journey. And but let me start first with saying, why is it so important that the ecosystem starts working together? So I'm super happy with the Virtuozzo ecosystem. So that means that Virtuozzo takes a lot of things very serious for her customers. And one of the things is cybersecurity. Here we can play a value-added part. And again, I'm not emphasizing that we have all the answers for your cybersecurity needs and challenges. But what I can assure you is that we know a lot about bot mitigation, and that's why this webinar is held, and we will take you through it.
Thank you.
Feel free to ask any questions in the chat or verbally later on. Back to you, Ahmed.
Thank you. Next slide. So as we explained in the previous webinars and this one, like, we are this year implementing an ecosystem series of webinars where Virtuozzo is not presenting the technologies, but we are presenting the technologies and the partners that are complementing our solutions. So we are trying to have one webinar a month, bringing one solution that can complement your Virtuozzo installation in your Virtuozzo cloud that you can propose or secure with your solution. So we did blockchain, we did research, today is security, and next month and the month after, we will be having other ISVs that will be bringing you value to the market. And from here, I handed it to Bertil, who will be explaining for us what are the security threats that we have today in the cybersecurity space and how BotGuard can help to mitigate all of them.
Thank you so much, Ahmed. And I said I'm pleased to be presenting today. I'm representing BotGuard. And if you separate the name in two parts, Bot and Guard, you already know exactly what our main focus is in business. We started our business back in 2019 when one of the two founders, actually the CTO, was working at a large financial institution. He got confronted with a lot of bot attacks and was asked to develop a, let's say, solution to prevent credit card fraud. And this was actually his journey towards what later became BotGuard. And in 2019, we founded the company based in Estonia. And as you might know, Estonia is one of the most advanced digital countries in the European Union. So we started our company there. Our CTO and the majority of our tech team works from that area, and hence our legislation is also governed by Estonian law. On the right-hand side, you see actually a picture, a pretty famous picture for everybody who travels regularly. I'm coming from Schiphol Airport as we speak, so I just passed these cyber security measurements, and I had hoped that it was so simple to catch the bots as you could let's say, catch a knife on the conveyor belt when going through security. BotGuard is operating in more than 30 countries as we speak and growing pretty rapidly. We have a follow-the-sun support system with more than 50 support engineers around the globe, whereas we try to support our premium partners as good as we can in a 7x24 setup. Of course, if you would like to be protected against malicious activities on the web, the best thing is not to go to the web. But in the current climate, it is not possible to run a company anymore without any web presence or even having the digital snail highway as your main source of sales or income or knowledge sharing. Hence, everybody who owns a website needs to take care of his security. And there are a couple of fields where we will touch on a little later where quite a few website owners don't think about. And if they don't think about it, we as ecosystem, hosting partners, but also software vendors supplying the hosting partners need to support this forefront of security. Because if a malicious activity doesn't hit the web server, it can't do any harm. That's the basis of our solution. Not letting the malicious software hit the web server and then start, let's say, defending or even repairing, but prohibit any malicious activity to hit the web server. And I'll show you a picture a little later on how we do that as a setup. So why would you care about bots? In our commercial discussions, feedback I get from the sales team members is that quite a few customers actually say, well, bots, I don't care about them. They don't bother me. I am a hoster. I'm just transporting information from A to B. And the more transport I can do, the better it is. This is, of course, in our vision, not very true, because bots have the tendency to become smarter and smarter and actually impersonate human activities. In principle, any website, whether it's a commercial website or just for information, is there for humans. So why would we allow automation to see, scrape, or view any of the activities on that website? And here we need to be aware of the fact that there are various different threats. So the one of the most fishy, most preliminary, or no, most elementary way of getting, for instance, access to portals is by sending out phishing emails. Spam is also considered as a web threat, and data loss, of course, is the biggest threat for any company. So if you look at the threat of data loss, 60% of the small mid-sized businesses who have a total loss of data will go bankrupt within 18 months after that occurrence. So losing your data or getting a GDPR compliance issue is no fun, and you really need to take good care of it. And we, as hosting industry, need to be able to tell our customers, hey guys, we have fixed everything for you in the best possible way at the current stand of the technology. So hence, you need to teach your teams about the history of cybersecurity threats, because if you know what the history is, you can also see where the future will be. The future is closer than you think. What type of bots can we recognize? Currently, we define that in two types of bots, the good bots and the bad bots. We already touched on the non-human traffic, and not all not human traffic is bad traffic. Take an example, if you have a monitoring service, that it can be considered as a bot, or you want to have the Google Analytics as statistics, those are good bots, and you don't want those to be blocked from any filter, because they provide you with valuable information to improve on your business and your consultancy. On the other end, we have the bad bots. And of course, that's the part where we talk about today. And today, 47% of all the web traffic on the free web is actually web traffic, bot traffic. And that number is growing year over year by about 8 to 10%. It's getting cheaper and cheaper to actually buy a bot. For instance, if you want to buy tickets for a music show, it's sometimes hard to get hold of those tickets for a very popular concert. So you take yourself a bot, pay 20, 30 euros for that bot, and it will hammer down the e-commerce website of the Ticketmaster to allow you to buy the tickets. These kind of bots we can easily prevent from hitting your web server because we can analyze the traffic, and based on the analytics, we can say, hey, this is a bot. We don't want that bot to hit the website, and we only want to allow human interfacing with our web server. 30% of all the inbound traffic on the web is generated by malicious bot. And a malicious bot for the one is maybe not a malicious bot for the other. But in the end, we qualify 30% of all the data traffic as malicious traffic. Now, if you have, for instance, a network in one of the bigger platforms, or you have a inbound and outbound measuring of your data traffic, this could be a very costly situation. That depends on the region where you are on the globe, how the traffic is managed. If you are peering away all your data traffic, of course, this data traffic cost is maybe not significant, but your pipe from and to the backbone will get congested, and that's, of course, will bring in the end additional cost with it. What we can see, and it's a trend, and we have here a number out of 2021, but it's actually a trend for the last 10, 15 years already, that cybercrime and data breaches are increasing year over year. The bad boys are getting smarter and smarter. And if you follow the news, cybersecurity police is getting smarter and smarter. This is a red race. The only challenge is we as the good guys, we need to comply to law and order. Whereas the bad guys, of course, do not comply to that. And they're always trying to stay ahead of the curve. Hence, we need to be smart and we need to work hard on making sure that the end customer is protected. So 83% of all the data breaches involve sensitive information. That can be an email address, that can be login parts, but it can go as far as your social security number. And I think it's one of the tasks for specifically hosting companies and managed service providers to do a risk analysis on these kind of potential threats for their customers and offer a service to mitigate that risk. And whether you do that with just a bot mitigation tool like BotGuard, or you use any other means of cybersecurity, I think anybody who is in this service industry needs to be aware of the threat level and needs to be educated on what he or she can buy in the market to prevent negative results of data theft or stolen sensitive information. The graphic designers did a good job here to create some characters of the various types of bots there are. Whether you like it or not, I think it's funny to explain the different types of bots with these icons. Scraper bots are not too familiar for a lot of people, but scraping your website can, combined with other scraped websites, become a business model for somebody else. And you need to think about whether or not you like it that somebody else is utilizing your information in his or her business concept, because in the end, it's your intellectual property. Of course, we don't like anybody to try and brute force get hold of your login credentials. So credential crackers are bots which try to enforce your login details and your to get access to your online shopping cards or your credit card information, etc. Spam bots, sending out mass market emails. We all know that, especially in the hosting industry, we see a lot of spam bots being used, but also the people running hosting industries are getting spammed quite a lot. And even the podcast salespeople do get back to me and say, hey, this person doesn't want to reply to my my email. Although the email is not unsolicited, it still is hypersensitive on how you approach somebody over the World Wide Web. So not all emails are spam, but spam can be considered irritating. Ad fraud. Ad fraud is a good business model for those who play, see this as good. Ad fraud means that a bot can push the eyeballs of a banner, for instance, pretty easily, and you're spending a lot of marketing money on data, which doesn't bring you any business. So being able to filter out any ad fraud or ad bots would already pay for the licensing fees you have to pay for any of the bot mitigation tools. Saying that, we at BotGuard do not believe in competition. We do believe in colleagues. We have quite a few good colleagues who we try to work together with to support the ecosystem in the best possible manner. How can bots impact your business? We already touched base on a couple of things. So brute force attacks, the well-known DDoS attacks can, of course, burn down your web server. This is no fun. Having a fire in your data center is not an easy thing to work with. And on the other hand, if your website is not available due to some person trying to block your business, that's impacting your cash position and the quality of service you want to deliver to your customers. So brute force attacks are the most common ways of bots being used. That results in overload of services. It all leads to financial losses. And of course, it damages your reputation. If you've ever had a data theft, all the things you have to do to get your, let's say, business back on track, that's no fun at all. So you better protect yourself and prevent data theft, because your customers will not hold still on this. And I think it's a good thing that the European Commission have launched the GDPR rules and the making sure that everybody has to report any data theft, because we as consumers, we definitely want to know if somebody is running around with my identity to go shopping with my credit card. Credit card fraud is one of the biggest things. That's the root cause of the BotGuard product. So our CTO Dennis started with credit card fraud prevention as one of his major tasks, and the result we see nowadays with the BotGuard gatekeeper, BotGuard load balancer, and the BotGuard server being the solution to prevent any credit card attempts of fraud through, let's say, an automated way of brute force entry to the data. So it is our interest to provide you with a strategic approach of how to prevent automated harmful business interrupting your services. That is what we try to leverage. Will we be able to have 100% protection up and running? Probably not. But what we can guarantee is that we do our utmost with the whole team to make it as good as possible. But as I said earlier, it is a red race between the good guys and the bad guys. And there will always be somebody who invents something new, and we have to respond to that. We already talked a little bit about scraping of your data. And I would like to make a comparison between cybersecurity and a house insurance. So if you have a house and you don't lock the door, your inventory insurance company will not pay out if any data is stolen. And this comparison also goes for any content on your website. if you don't take the minimum requirements, the lock on the door and lock the door when you go away from home, then you have no protection from your insurance company against theft of, let's say, your credit card information being stolen from your portal, or anybody scraping your intellectual property of any of your PDFs you've uploaded. So to ensure that your data is safe, you need to have a cybersecurity analysis done. And it's our strong recommendation that this risk analysis is being repeated year over year. In the same manner, you actually should review your insurance policies year over year. So if you do travel a lot, you probably want to have a continuous travel insurance policy. But if you stop traveling, like for instance during COVID, it doesn't make sense to have such a policy. So you could stop it and book that on a accidental manner. So by trip. Hence, reviewing regularly cybersecurity. How do I protect my websites? How do I protect my customers best? Is the best advice I can give you. Like I said, prevention is the best protection. Risk analysis is a part of that. And taking action on the weak points is, of course, a follow-up on the risk analysis. If we look at the six levels of defense, of course, bot traffic management is in our best interest as a BotGuard, because that's where we're good at. The products come normally with web application firewalling, meaning you can activate this firewall, which is a software-based firewall. If you do have hardware-based firewalls in your network, feel free to use those. They don't bite each other, or if they start biting each other, you can just switch off the web application firewalling to the best of your knowledge and needs. The content copying prevention is part of the intellectual property prevention. If you are publishing stuff which you don't want to be replicated with, for instance, artificial intelligence toolings, then you should take some measurements on protecting that data. If you look at what ChatGPT has done in the last couple of years and how popular it is nowadays compared to, let's say, 24 months ago, this is a changing dynamic. This dynamic is specifically in the education sector very popular. And of course, students don't like to type a lot. So scraping content from various websites and then copy-paste it into their thesis or any of the other reports they have to do for their studies is becoming more and more popular. On the other hand, a ChatGPT solution is not always meant to be used in a negative way. If I, for instance, want to write a job description, I could easily use ChatGPT to scrape a couple of websites and get a job description in a couple of minutes, which triggers me then to have the ideas of the output of the bot to build my own job description to the likings of what I want, or in this case, BotGuard. So what I do with ChatGPT is I create a text, I use the creativity and the unreleased knowledge I have to structure, for instance, a job description. So there are two ways of the using the bots, the good bots and the bad bots. And of course, if you have content you want to protect, then of course you would like to prevent the bot scraping the website. And if you don't care, you leave it open for others to use. But you need to make a conscious decision what you want the bot to do or not to do. On the right-hand side, we see the DDoS protection. DDoS, so denial of services attacks, are popular if you really want to block somebody's business. The bots executing it, we can filter them. And that is one part of the defense. Of course, rerouting the traffic to Nirvana is another part of the defense. I must be clear with you, we do not do the second part. So we do the prevention on, let's say, not allowing the bot to hit the server. But in the end, we don't have a humongous platform of servers around the globe to have handle all the millions of attacks. SSL management and content caching are two other ways of defense, and you should have a good look at that. For the more technical specialists amongst us, this is the high-level setup of the BotGuard filter environment. On the left-hand side, you see the internet traffic coming in through your router or firewall, or usually it's a combination of both. The data traffic gets, as a reverse proxy, rerouted to the BotGuard gatekeeper. BotGuard gatekeeper takes a digital fingerprint of the request, and the digital fingerprint gets copied and pushed to the through the load balancer. If you do have a pretty active website, we strongly recommend to use a N+1 setup. And then the digital fingerprint lands at the BotGuard server. And there the magic starts happening. The BotGuard server is the true filter. We check the digital fingerprint on many, many activities. We use multiple, let's say, routes to verify whether or not the request is a legitimate request. And after the fingerprint has been checked, there are two options. Option one, we let the request pass. So that's on the bottom side, the website is served. Of course, there is some latency in this game, depending a little bit, of course, on the network stability, on the type of connections between various servers, etc. But usually this latency is anywhere between 0.3 and 0.5 milliseconds. If we have a shared platform, then it also depends on where are the servers based. We usually try to have our servers in the 30 countries where we are active, so that the latency is as low as possible. If you have your own infrastructure, for instance, based on Virtuozzo, then of course we would love to have Virtuozzo containers with the BotGuard gatekeeper, the load balancer, and the BotGuard server in the same network for a humongous fast provisioning of the websites or the web servers which is requested. If the web server is found, the web request is found to be malicious, then we will serve a 403 page or any other custom landing page you so desire. And in that web page, you could say, well, we think you're a bot. We don't like bots. If you're not a bot, please contact system administrator, Mr. or Mrs. ABC. This is in a short schema how it the setup could work. And here you also see why there is a good collaboration needed between Virtuozzo and BotGuard, because Virtuozzo will provide you with the virtual machines and the infrastructure. And we will provide you with the images of the various servers to set up the filter system in an easy and quick to execute way. Once you have access to the BotGuard environment, you will see the events being listed. So every activity will be logged. Log files are available for free of charge for 1 month. If you do wish so, we can make them available for 3 months. And then you can see each and every web request, and also especially what is happening with that request. Is it denied, or is it is access granted? The top line, you see all security scrapers. Here you can go deeper and deeper in details on what how does your traffic look like, what do we figure out, and what do we block, what do we pass. So if you want to go a little bit deeper, you can go into the log files on an event detailed level. So this is where your, for instance, your support engineers could have a deep dive. And they can see all the related requests and what's happening with the requests. I'm just going to make a little bit speed because I had half an hour. So I'm 2 minutes out. This is actually one of the most important parts in the control panel of the BotGuard server solution. Here you see 8 questions, and based on those 8 questions, we do the preliminary setup of your infrastructure. Usually you can do it yourself. We're happy to support you with this, but based on these 8 questions and these settings, you can already filter approximately 80% of all your malicious bots. After you have run for instance, a proof of concept, and after a month after a week of testing, we will be able to see what is your average traffic look like. We start tweaking and start answering those questions, and then we will be able to set up the filters in such a way that it's hopefully a set and forget installation. Of course, like with any solution, you need to regularly have a look at it. It is like the threat assessment, an insurance policy. You buy it and you forget about it, but once in a while you have to look at it to see if it's accurate and still doing what you want it to do. After a couple of days, a couple of weeks, you might want to tweak your settings, and you have quite a few options to tweak. For instance, if you don't like data traffic coming from, for instance, Russia after they invaded Ukraine. We see this option being used quite often by our customers, because the hosts do not want to have to deal with anybody coming from the Russian territory. Hence, you can set the origin of the country where the request is coming from, and any data traffic coming from Russia in this case would be blocked. But you could also say, hey, I don't want any bots from the Netherlands, or I don't want any information from the Netherlands hitting my web server. Fine for you, it's your choice. One of the last slides, get started in 3 easy steps. So, of course, connect with our team or reach out to your Virtuozzo sales representative and they can connect you with us. What we will then probably do is we analyze your demands, your requests, your challenges, and 9 out of 10 times we start off with a proof of concept. We set up the proof of concept in such a way that it is easy to roll over to a production environment. And then, of course, after we've been running the proof of concept, we will know more about the behavior of your network, behavior of your customers, and we can create a perfect fitting financial statement for you. How does the licensing look like? Is that per domain? Is that per traffic? Is it? Do you want to host it yourself? Do you want us to host it or any of the MSPs to host it? These are questions we can figure out during the phase 2 and phase 3 of the onboarding. And for all the viewers of this event, we have a special Virtuozzo webinar call to action. You can get a 30-day free of trial, free of charge proof of concept. So we will do the consultancy. We'll work with you either on our installation or on your installation, whatever you prefer, and a 30-day free of production. So it's a 30 plus 30 offer for anybody who has been joining this webinar. This test is only this let's say discount is only available for those who are a Virtuozzo customer. So please contact your Virtuozzo representative if you want to carry out and be qualified for this beautiful offer. And with that, I would like to give the floor back to you, Ahmed. And that's 3 minutes over time. Sorry for that.
Yeah, thanks, Bertil. That was very, very good and very informative. So now it's the Q&A session. I don't know if our attendees have some questions. They can use the Q&A facility or they can use the chat. Better the Q&A so that everyone can see the question. And let's give 5 minutes if any question arises. Otherwise, we can close the webinar. If no questions, that means that you were to the point and very, very clear, which is cool.
Yeah. I do see, but I don't want to open up the chat session. But I do see four hints in the chat session that could also be internals, of course. So if one of the monitor auditors could have a look at it.
Yeah, I looked at it. There is no question there.
Okay.
I'm not seeing any question.
So Ahmed, what we are looking forward is working with your customer base, your teams, and I don't mind whether they're in Japan, in the UK, in the Americas. The call to action is available for everybody on your team side, and again, if people are referring to this webinar, we will and they reach out directly to us, we will also connect them to you, of course.
That's perfect. So I'm not seeing any question. I believe that everything was fine and very clear. So I thank everyone who came and joined us today. Thank you, Bertil, as well, for your presentation and your time. There is a question, sorry. Can you please provide the download links for the 60 days trial? For here, for this, Ricky, we need to contact your Virtuozzo sales account manager, and he will be gladly giving you and providing you the link.
Another question coming in. Yeah.
What differentiates the BotGuard product from Cloudflare, for example?
Very good question. Very good question. Cloudflare is one of our famous colleagues. Cloudflare has a very broad product portfolio. We are laser focused on bot mitigation. Cloudflare has many, many other solutions in place, including bot mitigation. Of course, they're famous for the DDoS attack mitigation. The biggest challenge, I would say, is in the licensing schema and the licensing pricing. The BotGuard solution is way cheaper, is laser focused, easy to implement, easy to handle, and easy to understand also for your end customers. I would say easier than the Cloudflare solution, although I don't like to bash about colleagues. It's a great product. They have a magnificent DDoS attack prevention hardware setup, but we are laser focused on supporting the SME, so small and mid-sized enterprises and smaller customers who are not able to afford themselves a BotGuard solution of a Cloudflare solution. But again, a great solution from Cloudflare, but very broad and very deep. I hope that answers your question.
Thanks, Sayed, for coming and joining us. Yeah, so let's wrap it up. Thanks everyone again. The recording of the webinar will be available on our website, as if you want to view it again. If you need a license or if you need a test license or test software, just be in touch with your Virtuozzo sales rep, and we are around in order to take you within this journey with BotGuard. Thanks, everyone. Have a good day, night, evening, morning, depending on where you are based in the world.
Thank you so much, Ahmed and Virtuozzo team, and looking forward to working with you again.
Thanks, Bertie. Have a good one.
Bye-bye.